You can make money just for shopping at Kroger? Well, yeah, pretty much. What it's called is retail arbitrage. And essentially, you're buying things at stores like Kroger, Walmart, Dollar Tree, Costco, wherever you shop at, and then selling them online to people who can't get them. You can call me WBK, and what I want to do is help you make some money. Retail arbitrage is not going to be a life-changing thing for everyone. You're not going to be a millionaire, but can it make you $2,000 a month more? Absolutely. And even more importantly, can it teach you the basics of e-commerce that allows you to scale your retail arbitrage side hustle into a full-time wholesale distribution business, into a full-time private label business? Absolutely. Like these Jolly Rancher gelatin desserts. Don't call them Jell-O packets. These Jolly Rancher gelatin desserts are in demand. People want them. They're selling for $1.19 at Kroger, but you get on eBay and they are selling for between $4 and $5 per pack. That's a huge difference. And as you bundle them up, you pay $3.80, $4.80 for four packets of gelatin dessert. You sell it for $16. Suddenly you're making some good money. These are kind of segues into wholesale, a great way that you can learn the basics while making some cash on the side too.
This is really an important thing to understand. If you can give people what they want when they want it, the retail price doesn't matter so much.
Right next to the gelatin dessert are these Godiva pudding packs. These are very in demand. They only cost $1.69 per pudding pack at Kroger, and on eBay, they're selling for quite a bit more. As you can see here, they are worth about $5 per pudding pack. That based off the $1.69 retail price. It's very easy to understand where the money comes from. This is not a mind-blowing concept, really. Making money in this sort of instance is just knowing how much things cost versus how much people are willing to pay for them.
One of the things I'm always hearing in these videos is people say Blake, and that's my middle name. WBK stands for Walter Blake Knobloch. They say, Blake, what about if everyone buys these and lists them and the market tanks? It gets flooded. The supply goes up, the demand stays the same, prices decrease. And yes, if that were to happen, prices would decrease in the short run. But here are two ways to get around that. One, be patient with the price that you personally believe is the market price. Don't collude, don't price fix. Use your own intelligence to pick your own price. And two, what I really recommend you do is don't buy the exact same things that I buy in these videos. I try and explain what I'm thinking when I buy them. I try to talk about some of the aspects that I think make them valuable. So take that knowledge, take that paradigm of retail arbitrage and apply it to your own circumstances. Look for your own things you can sell that maybe they're licensed by Jolly Rancher. Maybe they are in-demand products that sell for more when they're bundled up. One of the hardest things for a lot of new people to grasp is that this work, retail arbitrage, is not like an innate thing everyone knows how to do. I have scanned tens of thousands, maybe even hundreds of thousands of barcodes in my life. I have looked up countless products, and that's why I can do it so fast now. I have a feeling for it, but that feeling has to be cultivated.
We saw a few bundles on eBay, but what about bundles on Amazon? These Keebler cheese and peanut butter crackers, if you bundle them up, even though you charge less per item, because of the savings you're getting on shipping, you're making more money per packet. So what I would do for these is buy six of them, sell them in six packs. They're again a grocery item on Amazon, and a lot of you might say, hey, how do I get ungated for that? Well, don't worry, I have a link below that explains how to get ungated on grocery for Amazon very simply. I've talked about it more in other videos. I'm not gonna talk about it here, but just know if you're having issues, the link below will take care of it.
Now let's talk about something a bit more advanced. What you see here behind me is Clear Eyes eye drops. I sold a lot of them last year. Even though Amazon had them for $2.99, because of the way Amazon works with a buy box, because not everybody has Amazon Prime, you could price them higher and make some money that way. Now, what I've noticed over the past 3 months is the price on Amazon of these Clear Eyes eye drops has been going crazy. It's gone from $2.99 up to $5 and then down and then back up again. Why do they do that? Because they don't have a steady supply of products, so they're trying to ration them with higher prices. If you've been following the news, you know that this Q4 around Christmas time is going to be crazy for supply chains. There are going to be so many things out of stock. And so if you can predict or just track it in real time, what things cost more, what things have a more volatile price, you can capitalize on that. Let's use these Clear Eyes, for example.
What we're looking at here is the Keepa chart for a product on Amazon. Keepa is a paid service. They track lots of useful Amazon info, inventory levels, if it's out or not out, price, third-party seller price, all that good stuff. What we're seeing is that a year and a half ago, there was some crazy volatility. There was even complete outages of the product. And then 1, 2, 3, 4, maybe 5 times since then, there have also been moments of volatility. But recently, we're seeing a lot more volatility. All of these little orange triangles, those are prices of third-party sellers, so not Amazon. Oftentimes, they have the buy box. Oftentimes, they're the one who's making the sale. But as you can see, as Amazon's supply and price fluctuates, so does the price of third-party sellers. And if you can situate yourself as someone who can make money off of that, who can be patient until Amazon runs out, they're supplying people with what they need when they need it at the cost of, okay, maybe I'm not gonna have sales right away, then you can make some good money.
Okay, so you've slogged through the basics with me, but it wouldn't be a true WBK retail arbitrage video unless I showed you a crazy bolo, something selling for like 10 times more than the retail price, and I got them right here. Fruit infusions, I bought a bunch of them, lemon cucumber, and normally I'm like, is it really worth $10? Yes, these are so good, they're hard to find. I saw on the shelf a sorry for the inconvenience sticker, meaning they were out of stock, meaning people like these. You buy them for $1.50 in store, they sell for 10 bucks on eBay, you're making like $5 profit. It really is crazy. All of the fruit infusions, all of those were in demand. I saw bundles being sold. I saw individuals being sold. They expire May 19th, 2022. So kind of a short shelf life, but do I think these will have an after expiration date market? Absolutely, they're really good. Being able to recognize trends or recognize like how you can add value to a product, that's what separates those who lose money doing this from those who make it a lucrative side hustle or even a full-time job. And also, I want to know, while the video's like over basically, what do you think of those true lemon, lime, you know, the flavor concoctions? Where did I put it? I put it somewhere right here. These. What do you think of these? Because I love them. And if you comment, it'll, you know, boost engagement. All right, I'll see you later. Subscribe. Always do that. Thumbs up and subscribe.